major problems with special counsel Robert Mueller. In fact, I feel we're in the beginning stages of a constitutional crisis. Former FBI director and now special counsel on the bogus Trump-Russia collusion investigation, Robert Mueller, is a man completely out of control. Completely out of control. He operates without oversight or supervision. In fact, he's about to put the fear of God into his own bosses so he can operate completely unrestricted. This is incredibly dangerous. The man, Mueller, is light years beyond the intended scope of his investigation. He was supposed to simply investigate allegations of collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia to crush Hillary Clinton's hopes and dreams. And that last part doesn't sound too bad, right? But there was no collusion. This all stemmed from that phony dossier that was compiled by former British spy Christopher Steele, contracted by Fusion GPS, a far-left opposition research firm, and paid for, in most part, by the Hillary Clinton campaign, which appears to be done illegally because they funneled that money to pay for it through their law firm Perkins Coie so that the disclosures that they were paying for the dossier wouldn't be listed on the Federal Election Commission's website, wouldn't be transparent, so that you and I couldn't see that Hillary was behind it. Now, that's all Mueller should be investigating. But he's going after Manafort for old financial crimes. He's forcing guilty pleas on junior staffers because they misstated things to the FBI. The man is way out of control. But even worse, his investigation, if Mueller was an ethical, honest guy, his investigation would now shift to Hillary Clinton, to players inside the FBI like Andrew McCabe, and to Fusion GPS, because none of the allegations in the dossier can be substantiated. Not by Senate committees, not by House committees, not by their lawyers and investigators, and not even by the FBI. Not by the Department of Justice. The dossier is junk. It's kindling. Throw it in the fireplace on Thanksgiving Day. That's all it's good for. Yet Mueller is still on his witch hunt, trying to jam up people in the Trump family, the Trump administration, and I think the president himself. Why? Well, it appears he's a far-left deep state operator, but that's a whole nother show and segment. We've done it. We'll do it again. This show today is about his broad, dangerous, and really concerning overreach, because what Mueller is now doing is he's subpoenaing records and investigating his own bosses, Jeff Sessions and Rod Rosenstein. This is unheard of and unprecedented. Robert Mueller is not the Attorney General of the United States. He is not confirmed by the Senate. He operates, like I said earlier, without any oversight. This is so dangerous, it mirrors a banana republic. This is beyond J. Edgar Hoover keeping files on government officials. This is Soviet-era Lavrenti Beria, KGB, where you have an all-powerful law enforcement, intelligence, and prosecutorial entity that operates with impunity, not only doesn't have oversight, but when oversight steps in, it threatens oversight with smearing and prosecution. That's what's happening here. The president of the United States needs to shut Mueller down. Jeff Sessions is not the man for the job. Now, look, I was at a big conservative event this weekend, the David Horowitz Freedom Center Restoration Weekend, in Palm Beach, Florida. And all the speakers were A-list, Steve Bannon, Sebastian Gorka. And one of the interesting speeches I heard was J. Christian Adams, the DOJ whistleblower. Well, I had a chance to speak with him, and I had a very good conversation with Steve Bannon. And right after Bannon's speech, he was doing a Q&A for a small group, about 20 of us, and I'd gone over. Steve and I have crossed paths over the years, had a very nice chat about candidates and issues. And a woman, who's actually a friend of mine, asked him point blank in front of 20 people, "What about Jeff Sessions?" And to paraphrase Bannon, he basically said, "You know, we thought he was the right guy for the job. He's not the right guy for the job. He doesn't have what it takes." Those weren't his exact words, but that was essentially what he conveyed. And I believe he did say he's not the right guy for the job and essentially said he has to go. So the next day, that was on Saturday evening. The next day, on Sunday, I ran into J. Christian Adams, the DOJ whistleblower, in the hallway. And he had just given a speech where he excoriated Rod Rosenstein. And I was talking to him about Andrew McCabe and Jeff Sessions, because in that same speech where he excoriated Rod Rosenstein, he was praising Jeff Sessions and said, "Leave him alone. He's doing the job. He should stay, blah, 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 blah." So I grab J. Christian Adams in the hallway, and I asked him, hey, look, why did you say Sessions should stay there? And his answer really concerned me. The guy's a whistleblower, but he's not an ideological warrior. He's not a culture warrior, a media warrior. And he said, well, because Sessions knows how bad it is. He knows that you just can't rock the boat because they'll make your life worse. Now, he should fire Rosenstein, but he shouldn't fire Mueller because he's going to make things worse and they're going to come after them more aggressively. And I'm thinking to myself, this is ridiculous. That's the swamp. You're saying that even if things are done wrong, that Donald Trump unseated 16 establishment candidates, that we should just allow them to continue because if we don't, they're going to become more aggressive. Well, isn't that precisely why we put Donald Trump into the White House? To bust up the establishment cartels in both parties and to drain the swamp? Isn't that precisely why we gave the man the job? So to hear Adam say keep Sessions for the reasons he did only reaffirmed to me that Sessions is the wrong guy. Because Adams essentially said to me on the record, Sessions is playing the game with the swamp. He gets what they're about. He's afraid of them and he's letting them do what they do, which dispels all those kind of silly conspiracy theories on Twitter that there's this 5D chess being played by Jeff Sessions behind the scene and he's going to get Hillary. No, there's not. No, there's not. Sessions doesn't have what it takes to go up against the establishment that he himself has been part of for decades. But this goes back to Mueller. So now you've got a dossier that cannot be substantiated even by the FBI that was most likely used for FISA warrants. So either the judge was complicit when he issued those FISA warrants on unsubstantiated information, or the FBI and DOJ lied to the judge. Because the judge is most certainly going to ask, hey, this information came from a third party. You want me to issue a secret warrant to surveil American citizens? Is this information good? Did you substantiate it? That's what a judge asks law enforcement and prosecutors before issuing warrants. So either the judge knew it wasn't, which I don't believe, or those loyal to Team Hillary, Andrew McCabe, at the FBI and at DOJ, Rod Rosenstein, those loyal to the FBI, to Hillary Clinton at FBI and DOJ, quite possibly misled the judge by implying that the dossier was good. And Mueller needs to be looking into that. And if he isn't, it begs the question, why? Now, I firmly believe that Mueller's sole goal is to avenge his buddy James Comey. At this point, it's to avenge his buddy James Comey. And this is why he's now investigating Jeff Sessions and Rod Rosenstein, his bosses. That is a very scary prospect because he has no congressional oversight. He was never confirmed by the Senate. Those are the only two guys who can really shut him down. Well, the president can, but the president is, I fear, surrounded by people who are telling him, don't rock the boat. They're saying things that J. Christian Adams is telling the crowd. This is a concerning situation, and I do think it's a constitutional crisis. So you've got Mueller now investigating his own bosses to avenge his buddy James Comey. And again, this isn't conspiratorial. He's subpoenaing records from Jeff Sessions, from Rod Rosenstein, i.e. investigating them with regards to their roles in firing James Comey. So to summarize all this, you've got a non-appointed by the President of the United States, non-confirmed by the Senate, special counsel with unlimited investigatory and prosecutorial power, working without oversight, investigating his own bosses, probably has the fear of God in them because Sessions doesn't have any guts, and Rosenstein is an ally of the Comey, Clinton, Mueller faction. And the evidence is stacking up against him. Look, we know there's no Trump-Russia collusion. If the FBI can't substantiate the dossier or any of these allegations, we know it never happened. It is time for the President of the United States to shut the investigation down today. And it is time for him to fire Jeff Sessions. I've been saying Jeff Sessions needs to do something or find someone that would. No, he's doing nothing. That ship has sailed. That time has passed. President Trump needs to fire Jeff Sessions today, put in a wartime attorney general, shut down Mueller, and investigate everybody from Obama on down, from the Clintons on down, even people in the establishment GOP who weaponized the law enforcement and intelligence communities against a political campaign. This is the stuff of banana republics in Soviet-era Russia. This is not what happens in the United States of America. If you like this content and find it as interesting as I do, and as important as I do, because it's really important, please subscribe to our premium service at www.therebel.media/shows. If you're already a subscriber, thank you so much. Thanks for watching. I'll see you tomorrow.
I think he wants Jeff Sessions to resign. I think he wants him to be gone. And I think he then wants to fire the special prosecutor. Look, he has got a whole bunch of buzzards and other carrion animals that eat carrion looking over his shoulder. They want to kill him. I mean, Mr. Mueller, I'm sure he's a fine human being in many ways, but he's got that job because he wants to kill the political career and maybe take away the freedom of President Trump. He's not there for any other reason. Nobody takes that job, then hires 20 or 30 high-level Democrat prosecutors unless he's out to get the president. He's going to have to get rid of him eventually. He's going to have to get rid of Sessions. The whole idea of having a special prosecutor this early when there's no crime,
Ben, are you saying the president should get rid of Robert Mueller? That would be a bombshell.
Absolutely. It would be a bombshell, but I think it has to be done. I mean, Mueller has behaved in an extremely unprofessional way by having a deck stacked with so many left-wing Democrats and big-time Hillary contributors. That is not the way to run an impartial probe. And there shouldn't have been a special prosecutor in the first place. Nothing bad happened.
Well, we don't
Nothing
know. Well, the prosecutor, well, the probes are not completed yet. I hear what you're saying. The markets did fall early today. I hear what you're saying. The markets fell early today in the news that the special counsel is reportedly expanding the Russia probe now into Trump's business transaction after the president warned him not to do it. And it involves probing real estate deals and the like. And also, Ben, the Senate Judiciary just filed recently a deep dive documents request for similar information. I mean, Mueller does have a broad mandate